Prick up your ears.
The sound of DTM.
My car sounds like music to my ears.
My favorite sound? When the car is leaving the pits.
My favorite sound? The cheering of the fans.
Crank it up.
My favorite sound? The silence before the lights go green.
Full blast.
Downshifting from full speed.
When I rev up my engine to its absolute limit.
Too close to cool.
Cheering on the podium.
Be aware,
it's gonna be loud!
Are you ready for the final showdown? Welcome here at Hockenheimring. It is the final race of the DTM season 2016, and it is going to be super tight. And one man who knows what it's like to be fighting for the championship is Mr. DTM, Bernd Schneider. It's wonderful to have you here, Bernd. Now, obviously, it's all about Marco Wittmann and Edoardo Mortara. On the one hand, Marco keeping his cool and not being very impressed by the pressure. And then Edo really, really suffering from the pressure. So what do you think? What does your feeling say? Who's going to make it today?
I think especially Marco have a little advantage. He's leading the championship. He was the guy who made no mistake at all in the whole season. And it's definitely an advantage for him. But in DTM, you never know. I mean, the weather changed now. It's pretty warm. Yesterday, we thought that BMW suffered a bit end of the race. And we will see how it goes. And today, we have Gary Paffert in first, second place in the first row as well. And that it means it will be not easy for each of both. But of course, the advantages of Marco's side.
I'm sure it's going to be a super tight race and very exciting. But before we have a look at today's race, let's have a look at yesterday's race.
And what drama was to come in the race. Yesterday, it was Miguel Molina then and Antonio Felix da Costa on the front row as they headed into turn number one. It was Miguel Molina in the Audi that got his nose in front but ran so, so very wide. And as did a number of the cars, as you can see in the background here. Antonio Felix da Costa continuing to keep the pressure up as they went into turn number two. Edoardo Mortara then had got work to do, and that work was challenged really early on by that little touch that came from Timo Glock. In the meantime, Marco Wittmann was making his way up the field and found himself in the P2 position, which was to the delight of the BMW garage, less so for the Audis. But then Edoardo Mortara got Timo Glock back with a very, very good overtake through the hairpin. Miguel Molina running just a little bit wide then, and Edoardo Mortara next disposed of the Augusto Farfus car as the Edoardo Mortara machine had more DRSs available, and Hans-Jürgen Abt was delighted. Mike Rockenfeller was never going to make it too difficult for Edoardo Mortara to come past, and then he was right behind the Icewatch BMW of Tom Blomqvist, and then getting past that as well. So all of a sudden, Edoardo Mortara, towards the end of the race, had found the pace and had found his mojo and was on an absolute roll. Mike Rockenfeller also getting past Tom Blomqvist, the championship prediction at that point. It was Wittmann on 194, Mortara on 174. Looks of anguish across the garages, and then what an overtake from Edoardo Mortara. It was brave, it was bold, but above all else, it was absolutely successful as he found himself into a podium place. Could have never dreamt of that happening at the beginning of the race, but as they reached the checkered flag, it was going to be Molina that takes P1. And then it was P2 for Wittmann and P3 for Edoardo Mortara, who is with Verena right now on the grid.
And now I'm here with Edoardo Mortara. Edo, the drama continues. I mean, very nerve-wracking. Your technical problems today again, and not having set a time in the qualifying 4 minutes before the end, and then one place behind Marco in the qualifying or starting in the race today. So what went through your mind there? It was really nerve-wracking.
Well, I mean, for sure, you know, it wasn't the best qualification session that we had. And for sure, when you have like this kind of problem, it's never easy, you know, to keep your focus and, you know, and to keep working in the right way. But nevertheless, you know, when I'm saying like I'm fighting till the end, it's not words, you know, I try to do my best. And I think that in the end, you know, for the amount of running that we had, it wasn't so bad. We are starting from P6. We have also less weight now in the car compared to the others. I just hope that we can, you know, finish this race in the best way possible and try to get as many points as we can.
All right, best of luck, Edo, and back to you.
Here comes the starting grid then for what is going to be an exceptionally exciting race. Antonio Felix da Costa and Gary Paffett are on the front row. Row two is Tom Blomqvist and Maxime Martin. How crucial could it be that those two BMWs are there? Because when we get to the third row of the grid, it's the championship contenders going from P5, Marco Wittmann, going from P6, Eduardo Mortara. Then we find Robert Wickens at P7, Timo Glock is P8. To the fifth row, Christian Vitoris and Jamie Green. And then on the next row of the grid, we find Augusto Farfus and Bruno Spengler, two BMWs together on row six. P13 and 14 belong to Lucas Auer and Nico Müller for this, the final DTM race of 2016, which sees Felix Rosenqvist go from P15 and Adrien Tombé from P16. Mike Rockenfeller and Paul de Resta are on the ninth row of the grid, and as we get to the 10th, we find the cars of Martin Tomczyk and Timo Scheider both contesting their final DTM race. Then it's Daniel Junkadea and yesterday's winner, Miguel Molina. And right at the back of the grid, it's René Rast and Maximilian Gertz as we go back down to Verena now.
So I'm here with Marco Wittmann, or rather Marco is already sitting in the car. He didn't want to speak to me just before the race, which is of course understandable. He's very tense, obviously, but on the other hand, he's 17 points ahead of Eduardo Mortara, and he's also one position ahead of him in the race now. So I'm pretty sure that he is confident for hopefully snatching his second title in his career, but the tension's got to be said. Having looked in his eyes, he's very, very focused, and he does seem pretty tense, no wonder. So back to you.
Thank you, Verena. Some analysis there of just how Marco Wittmann is feeling as we look at Jamie Green, who is going from P10 on the grid. Of course, going into the race yesterday, there was still a mathematical outside chance that he could take the championship. It would need both Mortara and Wittmann to fall by the wayside, which of course didn't happen. So now Jamie Green is out of it, but nonetheless, he wants to finish the 2016 season on a high, as does each and every one of the drivers that's on the 24-strong grid of DTM cars here at Hockenheim. And here we can see Marco Wittmann then, who is keeping his visor down to hide the emotions from his eyes, I think. And as we look at Christian Vitoris, who will be going from P9 on the grid in the BWT Mercedes-AMG C63 DTM, which of course is run by Mucha Motorsport. Christian Vitoris, teammate to Lucas Auer in the all-pink machine. So Christian Vitoris then, final words with his engineer as the belts go on for the longer race of the two across any given DTM weekend, and this one of course featuring the mandatory pit stop where the teams can play such a part. Eduardo Mortara then is wished luck. He needs luck and he needs everything to go his way, and he needs a great drive. Qualifying didn't go his way, it has to be said, with technical issues. Timo Glock from qualifying managed to place his car on P8. Call from our summary of race one, just how Timo Glock muscled his way past Eduardo Mortara yesterday. As we look at Robert Wickens, who will be going from P7 on the grid, just behind one of those championship contenders, Eduardo Mortara, who of course will be starting from P6. So the Robert Wickens Mercedes-Benz then. And there we can see Robert Wickens in the final stages of preparation.
Thank you.
It's a Hockenheim ring, and it is the final race of DTM for 2016. And the grid contains Antonio Felix da Costa, Gary Paffett. On the front row, then it's Tom Blomqvist, Maxime Martin, Marco Wittmann, Edvardo Mortara, Robert Wickens, Timo Glock, Christian Vitoris, Jamie Green, Augusto Farfus, then it's Bruno Spengler before we find our Müller. Rosenqvist, Tom Bay, Rockenfeller, Paul de Resta, Martin Tomczyk and Timo Scheider, both of whom contest their final DTM races today. Daniel Juncker, Dea, Miguel Molina, René Rast and Maximilian Goertz. That's the way it looks. And the championship has gone all the way to the wire. P6, Edvardo Mortara. Alongside me, Leo Gorman from the motorsportarchive.com. He's the man that's got the work to do, Edvardo Mortara.
Absolutely, he's got an absolute ton of work to do, not just to get ahead of Wittmann, but there's other BMW drivers ahead of him. We mentioned earlier on after qualifying, you got Maxime Martin, Tom Blomqvist is there, Antonio Felix da Costa, not forgetting the Mercedes driver of Gary Paffett as well. So Martin has a lot of work ahead of him. And you know what? Wittmann alongside him on the third row, as we see the BMW on the grid now. So
Jens Marquardt from BMW is the head of BMW's DTM concern. I wonder how nervous he is. Verena will find out for us now.
I'm definitely going to try. Jens, yesterday we saw a really spectacular race. Today we saw a thrilling qualifying. Marco in P5 and a lot of BMWs all around him. So it looks pretty promising for snatching the second title. However, I tried to talk to Marco just before the race and he refused to talk to me. So he seems pretty tense. What do you think?
I would say he's focused. He's really focused, and that's what we need to be. Yeah, it's a tough job still for an hour. Pit stop, strategy, getting everything right. Qualifying was the first step, but now the second one comes, and that's really important. And I think that's what Marco is just focusing on. So I'm happy he's like that, because I know that I can rely on him, or we all can rely on him, and we can rely on the whole team. So that's our job now.
And hopefully Marco can also rely on his colleagues who are nearby him to hopefully protect him and help him a bit.
Well, for sure we'll do our job here. And I think on a day like that with fantastic weather, a lot of people that came out here, they just want to see a finale Furioso. I think it's all set for that. And I have full faith in Marco that he's going to deliver what he also expects from himself.
All right, Jens Marquardt, thank you very much. And best of luck for the last race in the DTM season. Back to you.
Thanks very much, Verena. So let's get it clear. Edvardo Mortara can only prevent Marco Wittmann from winning the DTM trophy. When he wins the race and Wittmann isn't in the top five, or when Wittmann finishes sixth, both drivers could have 202 points. But the higher number of victories would actually favour Edvardo Mortara. So bear that in mind. Head of Audi's DTM concern is Dieter Gass, and Verena has caught up with him right now.
Wow, so it's going to be a very, very tough race, that's for sure at the moment. Edo is just behind Wittmann, which is unfortunate. I mean, he was very unlucky in the qualifying. However, he managed to get to P6. But what do you need today in this race in order to make a title still happen? A very good tactic or even a bit of a miracle?
Well, we need a very good tactic. We need a very good pace. A bit of luck will help as well. I don't think a miracle, because we have seen what race performance we can have. I think we have to look forward, and that's what Edo is going to do. And then we see how it'll end up.
And quite frankly, how nervous are you?
Obviously, I'm a bit nervous, but I think yesterday was a bit worse.
Well, best of luck, Dieter Gass, and now off we go. So back to you.
Thanks very much, Verena, who makes her way off the grid. Thank you for your hard work. And I just wonder how nervous someone like Dieter Gass is. But, you know, the preparations Edvardo Mortara had, you know, from qualifying, which was dreadful for him with technical issues during qualifying, which meant that he was only able to set that P6 time right at the very, very end of the session. Didn't get much running lead, did he?
He didn't, but I think someone in Dieter's position, he's not necessarily nervous anymore, because they've done as much as they can with the preparation of the car. Still, they got one pit stop to go, but everything beyond that, it's down to the drivers who we see on screen at the moment. Edo Mortara on the left, Marco Wittmann on the right. This is going to be a very good race, Dave. I'm looking forward to this.
Absolutely. As we reach the conclusion of 2016 for DTM, there are the two championship contenders. Edvardo Mortara on the left-hand side, Marco Wittmann to the right-hand side. It's Audi versus BMW. Marco Wittmann, of course, would add the second title to his career as the cars are released on their formation lap now. 1 hour of hot rock and action to come from Hockenheim, from DTM. featuring, of course, that mandatory pit stop as well. It's going to be non-stop excitement. Strategy could play a part. Luck could play a part. As the drivers make their way through to turn two now. And then the left-hander, which is turn three, which leads on to the Parabolica. And the starting grid scrolling through on screen for you now. Hugely successful weekend for the DTM over the 3 days. Some 142,000 people have made their way into the circuit to enjoy the race action from DTM as the cars head up to the hairpin now. There we can see Mike Rockefeller, there's Paul de Resta. Martin Tomczyk, who of course, alongside Timo Scheider, will be starting his final DTM race. It was a very emotional press conference that we attended last night where Timo Scheider announced the fact that he would be leaving after this race, that his contract was not being renewed, and he will be set to pursue further motorsport avenues. Of course, he runs a single-seater racing team in ADAC Formula 4. He's also been competing in Rallycross, and there, just a few of the 142,500 people that have made their way into this cauldron of action.
And it was good to see last night the camaraderie between the Audi guys last night. Was all the rest of the Audi drivers were there. Timo was very, very emotional when making the announcement, and they all were there to kind of comfort him and also kind of celebrate his career, because it has been a very successful career for Timo. Two championships.
181 DTM races since 2010.
Very few reach that number, and very few reach it with that success.
Pascal Wehrlein there alongside Uli Fritz in the Mercedes-Benz garage. Pascal Wehrlein, who of course took the championship and went on to have a Formula One career. Eduardo Mortara on the left-hand side of the screen. Marco Wittmann on the right-hand side of the screen as the cars make their way onto and into their grid boxes. Tension in the BMW garage with Jens Marco and Stefan Reinhold to the very right-hand side of your picture, and Dieter Gassen and Jürgen App together there in the Audi garages as we pay our manufacturer visits just
five,
before the start
four,
of the race.
3, 2, 1. Stop. Perfect.
3, 2, 1.
Stop.
So watch out for the Joker on this grid, Dave, which, of course, the non-BMW and the non-Audi, which is, of course, Gary Paffett, P2, on the
last
front row
on the grid
for Mercedes.
So the last car on the grid, the green flag from the marshal at the rear, is the final race of the championship for 2016. It is the championship decider. As the light will go out from red, we will be racing. Good start from Antonio Felix da Costa. It was a good start from Marco Wittmann as well. It is a torrid start for Eduardo Mortara, who slots in behind the car of Robert Wickens. Jamie Green goes out wide, so too does Augusto Farfus as they head towards turn number two.
And it's a comeback from Mortara, who initially lost several positions, but he's going door to door with, I believe, Maxi Martin coming through the third corner. Hasn't really worked out for him too well. Meanwhile,
Jamie Green and Nico Müller get together. There was carnage there. We saw some panel work damaged and the dust was being kicked up as they make their way around the Parabolica for the first time, going into the hairpin.
And it's Mortara is actually making a dive for fifth place. And I think he's got Martin this time. He's got Blomqvist just ahead of him.
So Eduardo Mortara, who we're on board with now off the back of the hairpin, just makes a tiny adjustment to the brake bias there. Eduardo Mortara then running in P5. He's got the Tom Blomqvist BMW ahead of him, which is not advantageous because, of course, Tom Blomqvist, same manufacturer as the car that's running in ahead, and that is the car of Marco Wittmann, that is P3 at the moment. The race is being led by Antonio Felix da Costa. It's Gary Paffett that's P2. Eduardo Mortara, who we go back on board with now, has got the Tom Blomqvist car ahead of him. He needs to dispose of Blomqvist as quickly as he possibly can.
But of course, the other thing that's going to be on his mind, Dave, is he doesn't want to go through too much DRS. He doesn't want to overuse his tyres too soon as well, because that the Audi was strong late in the race yesterday, where the BMWs kind of fell away.
Well, DRS, of course, not enabled quite yet, but when it is, of course, the number of usages, and DRS gets enabled right now, so Mortara can certainly use that on Blomqvist, and Blomqvist will not have that on Wittmann because it's too far back. So that gives a huge advantage to Eduardo Mortara. So Blomqvist now is going to be really, really vulnerable. Edo Mortara. Come on, use the DRS, Eduardo Mortara, because Blomqvist cannot do so. So, yes, the rear wing goes down.
And he's going for it. He's turned to Parapolica. He's coming alongside. And I think Mortara, he's got around the outside of Blomqvist. And Blomqvist breaking very late and almost goes into the back of Mortara. And on the outside, he got Maxi Martin as well. But it looks as if Blomqvist is going to lose another position to his BMW rival.
So Eduardo Mortara on the team radio then as he makes his way. He's got that move done. In the meantime, Gary Paffett is attacking.
And he's going to the inside.
Gary Paffett is going for the race lead here.
He hasn't won in quite a long time. Goes off and rejoins the circuit just behind Acosta. He's fighting for this race victory. Oh, what a fantastic attempt by Gary Paffett, but didn't quite pull up this time. Will he go to the inside? No, no, yes, he does. Does.
Yes, he does.
He's into the stadium section.
So can Gary Paffett pull off the move of the race so far? He's certainly pushing Antonio Felix da Costa, who, of course, is also starting his final DTM race, as well as Martin Tomczyk and Timo Scheider. But there is Eduardo Mortara, who has got past Tom Blomqvist and is now right behind his championship leading Marco Wittmann, his biggest competitor in this. If Eduardo, it would be such a confidence boost if Mortara was able to get past Wittmann. In the meantime, Antonio Felix da Costa for BMW then leads the way. Gary Paffett continues to chase in P2.
And of course, we've got da Costa out front in the BMW. Wittmann third place in the BMW. And the sandwich there is Gary Paffett and Mercedes. Mortara fourth place in the Audi. He does not have any Audi steel bits ahead of him to maybe assist him in his fight for this win.
Yes, but what he has done, he's already made great headway, hasn't he? And as Gary Paffett goes to the outside now of Antonio Felix da Costa, he'll try and get the switch back now. And I think he could be successful. He's on the power. Once again, he's side by side. This will give him the inside.
Okay.
Tom Blomqvist and Edo Mortara fighting behind as well. Gary Paffett and Antonio Felix da Costa rubbing panels together there as Paffett goes for a switchback once again. He is absolutely determined to finish the 2016 season on a high.
Fantastic action from the top two, but da Costa and Wittmann also trying to be careful not to get taken out should there be any incident directly in front of him. But Paffett is really pushing da Costa hard for the race victory today.
Yes, he is, and of course he is really in a very, very, he's unaffected by the championship chase, and it doesn't matter to him. What he wants is the race win and a bit of glory for Mercedes-Benz. Antonio Felix da Costa continues to lead. There is Eduardo Mortara then, who is running in P4 and came under attack again from Tom Blomqvist just a few metres ago, but was able to withstand that attack. So Eduardo Mortara continues to make progress in replay. You can see here how close Antonio Felix da Costa and Gary Paffett got together there. And
DRS.
What that could do is play into the hands, of course, of Marco Wittmann, but it hasn't done so yet. In the meantime,
and this is the moment when Mortara made the move down the inside of her.
It was really decisive, and it was a really, really good move.
He needed it. He needed it.
Right, with, of course, Antonio Felix da Costa does not have DRS available to him, whereas Gary Paffett does, and he's chasing him all the way to the hairpin now. Once again, they lock horns together. Paffett to the outside will try and dive up the inside now. Oh, and
oh,
Eduardo Mortara gets touched by Tom Blomqvist. Apologies for any colourful language from Eduardo Mortara, but he is trying his damnedest.
Oh, and it hits.
We see that, don't worry.
Paffett has gone into the back of the course and spun him around. He leads the race, but Wittmann going to the inside. Exiting Mercedes corner, and here comes Mortara for the lead.
Sorry, guys, he closed the door too late.
He closed the door too late, says Gary Paffett. Eduardo Mortara takes a look at the inside of Marco Wittmann. Gary Paffett is leading the race now from Marco Wittmann.
Yeah, keep pushing. Keep your head down.
So keep your head down, Gary Paffett, his engineer tells him. So, under investigation, copy. That situation that we've just seen. Bearing in mind, Mercedes are looking strong in the early stages of this race, particularly under the guidance of Gary Paffett, because he now leads this race. Marco Wittmann is P2, P1 in the championship. Eduardo Mortara is P3 in the race, P2 in the championship, and he's chasing down the BMW driver ahead of him.
He needs to take Wittmann. He absolutely needs to take Wittmann very quickly, because we could have a the stewards are looking at that incident with Paffett.
Well, it could be. Well, we will find out once the investigation is completed if there are any penalties or whether it will be adjudged to be a racing incident. Of course, all our focus is on P2 and P3 at the moment because that is our championship contenders, Marco Wittmann and Eduardo Mortara, who are running P2 and P3, and they're heading up towards the hairpin now. Edo Mortara has been really, really good and late on the brakes going into the hairpin, and that has proved to be so successful in some of his overtakes, his decisive overtakes thus far. Gary Paffett will not have DRS available to him, whereas Marco Wittmann and Eduardo Mortara will. And Paffett gets a drive-through penalty. Wittmann will lead the race.
And I think, to be honest, that's probably not the most controversial decision in the world. Paffett really just went into nerfed.
Paffett, drive through, try to overtake before.
For drive through on this lap, will exit in free air to push.
Here it is again in replay.
Yeah, I'm not totally convinced.
Well, that's the first time we've seen it in replay. Here we can see it from on board with Gary Paffett.
Yeah, he said that the Costa was kind of moving around. I'm not convinced. I think that he just took too much speed in. Maybe the Costa broke a little bit earlier than he normally would. But still, you know, it's Paffett who's actually gone into the back of the Costa.
And Paffett is straight in. So the shape of this race changes now because we have the championship leader, Marco Wittmann, leading the race with the championship chaser, Eduardo Mortara, in P2.
And that's dropped Paffett right down to the absolute back of the field.
So Paffett rejoins now. We're on board with him. And where is he going to come out?
I think he's actually... It's only Tombe behind him. So, yeah, he's P23. It's Edo Mortara right behind.
Edo, of course, has got DRS now and goes to the outside of Marco Wittmann. Wittmann, though, covers it off. Edo now will try the switchback and try and get the momentum going in because that would give him the inside line for the next turn. He's not far enough ahead yet, but he is now. Eduardo Mortara overtakes Marco Wittmann and closes the door. So P2 in the championship becomes P1 in the race. There's a little bit of a lock-up from Marco Wittmann. But Eduardo Mortara now leads this race. Marco Wittmann has got Tom Blomqvist right behind him, who's surely not going to challenge him for the P2 position.
But P4, that's key, because that is Christian Vietoris. Absolutely no cares whatsoever about the championship battle that's happening ahead of him. But he's going to want those positions. He's going to want the podium. And he has no consideration for overtaking Blomqvist or overtaking Wittmann ahead of him.
So Edo Mortara then leads Marco Wittmann, and this is how he did it. It was a perfect execution of that switchback, wasn't it? He got just enough momentum coming out of the hairpin to get right alongside the Marco Wittmann car, which would give him the inside line for the next turn, and he then promptly closes the door. Here we can see it from being on board with the Eduardo Mortara car, an absolutely brilliant overtake. Eduardo Mortara is on a mission here.
But Mortara is doing what he needs to do. He needs to win this race. If Wittmann comes outside the top five and Mortara wins, fantastic. But Mortara cannot do any more than what he's doing at the moment. So
no, he can't. You're absolutely right. And he has put himself in the position. But of course, do bear in mind now, Eduardo Mortara needs to open up a gap over Marco Wittmann so that Marco Wittmann doesn't have the DRS available to him. It's only 6 tenths at the moment.
Yeah, but he's already pulled another 2-3 tenths out on the first sector alone. I think he's going to be out of the DRS very, very quickly. Wittmann doesn't look as if he actually has the strongest of pace as they come into the stadium section, but we'll see over the next couple of laps because Wittmann now is not actually getting challenged from behind by Blomqvist. He's concentrating on his own race. Is the incident between Lucas Arra and Adrian Tombe? We didn't see that, but that has been investigated by the stewards.
There is the championship prediction at the moment. Now, the best opportunity Eduardo Mortara ironically has here is from Mercedes-Benz, because look where the next best Audi is on your timing screen.
14th place, Timo Scheiter.
He's got no support, Eduardo Mortara.
Absolutely not whatsoever. The first few laps of the race, apart from Mortara, it's not worked out in Audi's favour whatsoever.
What he needs is Christian Vietoris, Paul de Resta, and even Robert Wickens to try and overtake those BMWs ahead.
And we would never at any stage in the season would have thought, oh, Audi are looking for a little bit of help from Mercedes, even if it's requested or not.
No. Right. Well, Eduardo Mortara is doing everything he can. You can see that the championship prediction that we put on screen just a few moments ago, the way things stand at the moment, it is not enough. But in fairness to Edo, he can do no more.
07 behind you.
So Pitman still within DRS because he's only 7/10 behind Edo Mortara. But I tend to agree with you that Edo looks to have a slight pace advantage over Marco Pitman.
Plus as well, Pitman has DRS, Mortara does not. As we see Farfus having a battle with, I believe that's Tomczyk going through to take eighth place. Tomczyk in his final DTM race before setting off to GT land.
Yes, he's going off to pastures GT-like. This is Eduardo Mortara, sets the fastest lap at 1:35.470. It comes on at lap 7. So no help for Eduardo Mortara. Of course, things will change when it comes into the pit stop window because everyone will get out of position and that might help him. But at the moment, he still has Marco Pitman chasing him down, but he's got 7/10 over him at the moment as they go into the stadium section here. Around the banking or just a little mistake there from Eduardo Mortara, which may have cost him 1/100 or 2, but they can ask no more of him. He is winning the race. He's leading the race.
But Dave, if you're Marco Pitman and you're BMW, what do you say to Marco? You don't need to actually do any more. He doesn't need to overuse his tyres. He doesn't need to go through his DRS. All he needs is, as long as he sits in that top five, the title is his. Now, obviously, every driver wants to win their championship by winning the final race, but second place right now for Marco gives him a 10-point advantage at the end of today.
Here's the replay at the start. Gary Pappett was not as quick away from the start, and there you can see the start line reactions there.
But like yesterday, Mortara, yet again, yesterday also had a very poor, sluggish start. That's 2 days in a row that he's been slow off the line, and that's what's losing him momentum in the early laps. He cannot afford to do that.
It's a brilliant start from Daniel Yokodea further down the order as well, and we find him in P13 now. So as we continue to watch the replay, Jamie Green just got almost airborne there, didn't he, as they ran over the curbs through turn number one.
I didn't think he was actually flying back until tomorrow.
Boom. right, and here we can see it from being on board with Marco Pitman. It was a blistering start from Marco Pitman, but room wasn't made available to him by Maxime Martin, that's for sure. So
no, his initial getaway was actually good, but as they unfolded towards turn one, he just didn't have the room. Coming towards turn two, the inside opened up, and his BMW teammates, it didn't make it overly easy, but they did allow him to take up one or two positions. As the guy you've just seen out of the picture, Tom Blomqvist, fell down to fifth.
Under investigation was Lucas Auer and Adrian Tombay for an incident earlier on, and Adrian Tombay is going to get a drive-through penalty for causing a collision. Now, I wonder whether Audi could use that in their favour in terms of when they bring Adrian Tombay in for that drive-through penalty. Where is he on track at the moment? He's running right at the back of the order, isn't he? Mm. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, I do. If they delay the drive-through long enough, then actually, you have to take it within 3 laps.
Yes. But he's right at the end. Well, he's in now.
He's come in now, so. And I don't think that applause was necessarily for Tombay's drive-through penalty. But
this in replay then. Zedo Mortara muscle alongside Tom Blomqvist and also Maxime Martin in his quest to get up the road. And it was at that point that he was on the radio. And there we could see where Lucas Auer had gone round. And that was the incident that has caused Adrian Tombay to have to serve that drive-through penalty. And this was what it was like being on board with Eduardo Mortara. But it was a fantastic overtake that he made here as he got past Marco Pitman on the exit of the hairpin. Absolutely brilliant job done. The margin between the two of them then is 8/10, as you can see. And Eduardo Mortara clearly got the pace in the Audi. But as you say, Marco Pitman actually can just sit tight, can't he?
Yeah.
He's well protected behind by a string of Mercedes-Benz. There's the after-start ranking on the left-hand side of your screen. Up 5, Eduardo Mortara. Up 3, Marco Pitman. Up 11 places, Paul Di Resta.
And Martin Tomczyk as well. This may come down to obviously pit stop strategies, as we will see shortly in this race, but also, as we noted a few moments ago, what Christian Vitoris does. He's currently just over half a second behind Tom Blomqvist in third place. He is the only driver in the immediate reach of the top three who can actually shake up the order.
Not at the moment showing the pace that he's likely to do that. So, Mortara then, it's 9/10 and he sets another fastest lap, 1:35.423. Clearly, whatever technical issues they had during qualifying, they've got it sorted out so far because Eduardo Mortara's car running really, really well ahead of Marco Pitman. And Christian Vettori, he's just clear. He's got past Maxime Martin and he's closing on Tom Blomqvist. So this could be crucial if Christian Vettori and Paul de Resta and Robert Wickens, that could, those Mercedes-Benz drivers, that could really actually end up assisting Audi here. But we will see, as we've still got 42, 43 minutes in the race still to come.
What we potentially could see, it really depends on when Wittmann is pitted. BMW may not want to pit him too early, for the simple reason you have all the Audi drivers from 14th on backwards. The gap between Wittmann to Rocky in 14th place is only just over 14 seconds. A pit stop, what, 20, 23 seconds? 23. It could potentially drop him into an Audi pack.
Yes.
And if Audi leave the drivers in the bottom half of the field out for longer and maybe, you know, play games, shall we say, with Marco Wittmann, you know, that's not something that BMW need to do now.
So Edo Mortara then has taken another 3 tenths, and now 1.2 seconds up the road. Look, so Wittmann does not have DRS available to him. Edo Mortara, the fastest laps that he's been producing consistently.
Balance and pressures. Copy. He's out.
Pressures are fine, but I surrender with rear.
Edo looking really comfortable. Copy. There. Team radio absolutely live as Marco Wittmann is under a bit of pressure there from Tom Blomqvist. I don't think Tom is going to make a move on him, but all of a sudden Christian Vettori is playing into this now, and Christian Vettori could.
What is kind of critical as well for Audi, for Mortara, when do you stop Mortara? Do you kind of stop at just any time and allow them to feed into the pack, or do you wait until maybe there's a break between Jamie Green in 18th place and Antonio Felix da Costa, the BMW driver, in 19th? You have a bunch of Audi drivers in front of them who may just fall out of the way, shall we say, but you don't want to get locked behind another BMW driver once you've done your pit stop, because the chance of getting past are going to be made much more difficult.
Well, the strategist will be working on that basis straight away, won't they, looking at when is going to be optimum to bring him in. So at the moment, Mortara leading them by 1.2 seconds over Marco Wittmann. Tom Blomqvist is running in P3. The Mercedes driver, Christian Vettori, is P4. Then it's Maxime Martin, Timo Glock, before we get to another Mercedes, which is Paul de Resta. Martin Tomczyk in 8, Robert Wickens P9, and Felix Rosenqvist runs in P10. Those are your top 10. There is Timo Scheider then, who is currently running P15. He who will not be returning to DTM in 2017. And there you can see the Timo Scheider car, the very emotional press conference last night when he announced that he will not be returning. So in comes the number 8 car of Christian Vettori. It's a slowish stop, 3.5 seconds from Mucha Motorsport as Christian Vettori makes his way back out onto the track now.
And also Jamie Green in there as well. He's fallen. Oh, it's a bit, that looks a bit slow, I think, from the Audi boys. I think they lost a small bit of time there.
So the green P on the left-hand side of your screen indicates those that have been in and those that have not been in. Christian Vettori and Jamie Green being chosen to come in very early on. There is Eduardo Mortara. My guess is that they will keep Edo out for some time, particularly given the lap times that he's been able to produce at the moment. He's in the 135s. Everyone else is either in 36s or 37s. So Eduardo Mortara's got tremendous pace. What he doesn't have is Marco Wittmann. Enough down the order that this would be enough for Marco Wittmann to lose the championship to Eduardo Mortara.
The other element, Dave, is the field is actually still, you know, quite compact. There's no real need for either Mortara or Wittmann to pit right now, because all it will do is drop them into traffic. Now, as we mentioned a few moments ago, you could get friendly traffic if Edo Mortara, yes, you fall behind all the Audi drivers and they just move out of the way. But it's still, no matter what, you're going to lose time.
Yes.
When you fall into the field, you need to be the gap to open up. So when you make your pit stop, you fall into a little bit of clean air that gives you the ability to run cleanly and run freely. As we see,
in comes Paul de Resta. And Eduardo Mortara, last time around, was another 3 tenths quicker than Marco Wittmann. He really has got pace, extraordinary pace. It's 2.2 seconds to the good. Here comes Paul de Resta then from P6.
I think we saw this yesterday, Dave. Wittmann's race pace wasn't actually necessarily as strong as we anticipated.
That's more like it. 2.5 seconds, isn't it?
That's what you're looking for in a DTM stop. 2.5 seconds. Once it goes over 3 seconds, you're losing time to your competitors.
So Paul de Resta comes back out onto track then. And here is Eduardo Mortara, who is our race leader, but he's P2 in the championship. championship prediction as it stands at the moment. It'd still be plenty enough for Marco Wittmann to take the title. We've got 38 minutes of racing still to come from this final race of DTM for 2016. There is Marco Wittmann, looking pretty comfortable there in P2. He's protected by, of course, Tom Blomqvist and also Maxime Martin, and come to that, Timo Glock as well, and Timo Glock is running in P5. In the meantime, Gary Papert fighting his way back, ironically, with Antonio Felix da Costa once again. Antonio Felix da Costa, who, of course, is contesting his final DTM race.
I think da Costa's gone through there. He has. Not quite. Gary Papert fights back as they come through. Mercedes boys don't have another hit. That is, I believe, the call that's going to be coming down the radio. But Christian Vitoris, he's going to try and dispose of da Costa this time round. He got offline, which kind of made him lose a bit of pace. I'll tell you what, da Costa's looking fighty with the Mercedes competitors.
Well, he gets hustled away now, and he's got Maximilian Gertz right behind him as well.
And I think he's lost a wing mirror in that door banging with Vitoris there. And I think Vitoris lost his right side wing mirror too.
In comes Robert Wickens, also Felix Rosenqvist. So the Mercedes drivers all coming in, aren't they? The only one that's non-Mercedes so far that's been in is Jamie Green. So they go to work on the Felix Rosenqvist car. That's not as quick a stop as we have seen.
No.
There's a problem there. It's late down on the jacks. Felix Rosenqvist back out into the pit lane once again.
Very slow away on that incident for Mercedes. As Jamie Green coming round turn one is going to easily take Rosenqvist. Green, of course, fully up the speed, and Rosenqvist just getting on the throttle now as he enters into turn two.
Jamie Green, of course, has already done his pit stop. So here's Bruno Spengler and now Augusto Farfus with Daniel Junquetea. It's the fight that's going on for P7, P8 and P9 at the moment. There, up the inside of Augusto Farfus now goes the Daniel Junquetea car. And Mike Rockefeller trying to have a go as well and doesn't quite able to make it work. And Timo Scheider is in the mix too, right behind Mike Rockefeller. So we continue to watch this battle. Tara and Wittmann and Blomqvist all stay out at the moment. There's Bruno Spengler then, who's running in P8. Then the rest of the cars. Daniel Junquetea looking very lively indeed, having got past Augusto Farfus.
The thing is, Dave, you see this with Wittmann, you see this with Spengler and some of the other Farfus as well. The actual BMW pace at the moment is really not as strong.
No.
As we assume, it's the mid to late 1 minute 36s where you have Mortara, etc. He's still in the 35. Several other drivers in the field are in the early 36s.
Bernd Schneider made the point, didn't he, when Verena interviewed him, that it's slightly warmer and that might be better for the Mercedes cars. And, to be fair, we're seeing a far better performance from certain Mercedes cars than we are or have done all weekend long, as we see Martin Tomczyk then. And he's currently running in P6, one of his best positions of the season, to be fair. And Antonio Felix da Costa is being given the black and white flag for a dangerous maneuver. We're on board with Martin Tomczyk. And
ran a bit wide there coming into the hairpin, actually lost a little bit of time. Good performance so far by Martin Tomczyk on his final.
Mike Rockefeller on Augusto Farfus through the hairpin. He did that without a problem at all, didn't he?
Well, I think Farfus didn't just leave the door open, he left an entire barn door open, and Rocky just saw the gap and said, I'm having that, thank you very much.
Timo Scheider about to have a go as well. Augusto Farfus now to the outside. Timo Scheider will try and go up the inside. There'll be contact, will there, between the two of them?
And
yes, there is, and Augusto Farfus does a complete 360. So Augusto Farfus,
yeah, we saw.
Straight on the team radio, will be very, very disappointed with that. Could see that coming from a mile off, couldn't you? It was obvious that Timo Scheider was going to go for the inside. And I have to say, did you not feel that Augusto Farfus left the door wide open? Let's see it again.
He did, but there's also a point when you have
He's got to turn in, I accept that.
I think that was just not quite...
It's very good avoidance by Nico Müller as well.
Absolutely,
who collected
wasn't it? Yeah. But I mean, that I think that was easily avoidable by Scheider in this instance.
And there is Christian Vitoris then on Augusto Farfus. And I'll tell you what, look at the pace that Gary Papert has got as he's making his way back up the order following his earlier drive-through penalty. Bear in mind, he was leading the race. So of those that have stopped, we've got Vitoris, Duresta, Junquetea, Wickens, Green, Felix Rosenqvist, Adrian Tombay.
The key thing, Dave, in this instance, is some of the drivers who have pitted already are actually in the 35s. They're making up a second a lap on some of the drivers who are ahead of them who haven't stopped yet. the actual heat this afternoon could be doing an awful lot more to the tyres than some of the teams had probably initially considered.
Edo Mortara has opened up a gap of, let's see it live on screen for you now, it was 3.8. Look at that, it's now 4.3 in the space of a lap. He's added another 0.4. The pace advantage he has over Marco Wittmann. Timo Scheider gets a drive-through penalty now. That could be pivotal because an Audi driver with a drive-through penalty driving his final race in DTM.
I think it's frustrating to a degree. Wittmann, had that been other competitors behind Wittmann?
We need some quali laps now.
Had that been other manufacturers' drivers behind Wittmann, I think he would have been on so much pressure because the pace simply hasn't been there for the last several laps for Wittmann. And he's very lucky, I think, at this time that he has just got Blomqvist and he has got Martin and Glock kind of sitting behind him, protecting his rear.
Here comes Timo Scheider then. Now this is probably for his drive-through penalty rather than his mandatory pit stop.
Yeah, and do you know, I think that's not how he wanted to end his DTM career at all.
So Mortara leads by 4.3 seconds, but even though he leads by 4.3 seconds, it's not enough. Augusto Farfus then. Oh, and that's a hideously long time for our Augusto Farfus.
No,
that is a retirement time, isn't it?
It is. I wonder if he's actually taken significant damage to the wheel in that incident with Scheider.
Lucas Auer makes his way out, but look, the Augusto Farfus BMW is not going anywhere at the moment.
Question, Dave.
Yes.
If you're Marco Wittmann and you're 4.3 seconds behind the race leader, and you're
they do get him going again.
Oh, very good. But you're losing pace. But if you pit now, it actually will drop you behind Rocky, Muller, Molina, Scheider, Rast. Do you bring him in, or do you continue to play the risk that your pace isn't good enough?
Yeah, the problem is, you know, you have got to pit. There's no question about that. Of course, you're trying to look for the optimum time of when to pit, but you know what? The strategist can sometimes get it wrong as well.
I think maybe it's possible, and at this time I say it's possible, but if the Audi drivers stay out and they keep reasonable time, the best time for Wittmann to pit may have actually just gone already.
Yeah, you might be right.
There's still a lot to play in this race.
Well, we're just 30 seconds away from reaching half distance in the race, and the race is being led by this man, Eduardo Mortara, who's 4.5 seconds to the good over the man that's leading the championship, Marco Wittmann, who is P2. Martin Tomczyk comes in for his mandatory pit stop, and he makes his way back out on track once again. The other consideration, of course, is that BMW will be looking at this and deciding when to bring in their drivers.
Very good.
When to bring in their drivers to have maximum impact on Eduardo Mortara.
And I think, really, they've actually brought in most of their drivers, but the key ones they're looking at are going to be Blomqvist, Martin and Glock. But the problem with those three drivers is they're all 6.6 and 9.3 seconds behind Mortara. Probably just a little bit too far behind to be able to make an impact on fresher tyres.
Well, Mortara, again, is lapping in the 135.7s. You know, he has got pace. He really has got the pace, but at the risk of repeating myself, it's not enough, because whatever margin he leads by, whatever margin he wins the race by, unless Wittmann drops off, it's not enough.
The thing is, we heard on radio a few moments ago the BMW pit wall saying, Marco, you need to do quali laps. Well, he has raced this game, because I think they realise now that if they pit, they're going to fall into a long line of Audi drivers. I think Audi are going to leave Rocky, Muller, Molina and Rast out for quite a few laps, just in case Wittmann does pit and drops in behind them, because that could be a lot of positions that Wittmann loses instantly.
Right. Blomqvist now in means Vitoris will go past Blomqvist. So
yes.
There is Vitoris.
And that's what they're losing. That is what they're losing each lap around with Wittmann. They're losing half a second, 1 second a lap.
So Vitoris goes ahead of Tom Blomqvist now. So Christian Vitoris, who of course served his mandatory pit stop much earlier on. There's Edo Mortara. Look at that. You know, you can almost, it has to be the right camera angle to get P1 and P2 into the same shot now.
Mortara is he's doing his job. He's done all he needs to do. He's got to the front. It really is up to everything else that happens behind him now.
Lady Luck has got to play a part now, I'm afraid to say. So, Eduardo Mortara, look at the last three laps. You could see on screen. And Marco Wittmann then, who is running in P2. Currently, the way it is, it would be enough for Marco Wittmann to take the championship. No question about that. But, Edo coming in this time? No.
Dave, the gap between Wittmann down to Vitoris and Rast, it's not enough.
No.
I think if he pits, he actually ends up behind those two drivers.
Yep.
And as it also depends what happens with the other Audis behind him.
So there is Marco Wittmann then, who too was told just a few moments ago, up your game.
And also watch Rapal, the rest of P12, he's also done his mandatory pit stop. He's going to come into the game as the laps tick off as well. It's tense, Dave, isn't it?
Tense. It's extraordinary. We're into the final half an hour of this race, and there's still an awful lot to play out. Here comes Gary Paffett now. Second visit into the pit lane. The first one was for a drive-through penalty, but now Gary Paffett comes in for his mandatory pit stop in the Mercedes-Benz car. The team are standing by for him. We'll probably run the clock on his pit time to see what they do. The ART team stop now. They go to work. We do run the clock.
That's nearly 2 seconds lost in the pits. And this is the other concern that the BMW guys are going to have. This pit stop, if they're to get out ahead of the Audi guys, it has to be inch perfect. You cannot make a mistake. It could be the difference.
So Marco Wittmann on the live team radio.
Copy, lock up.
There's Eduardo Mortara leading the race. There's Marco Wittmann, who is P2. Edo has got a 5.1-second margin over this man running in P2. Equally, he's got a couple of seconds over Maxime Martin, who is running in P3. Then it's Timo Glock and Bruno Spengler before we get to an Audi, which is Mike Rockenfeller.
But those Audis, Rocky 6, Muller 7, Molina 8, they're all running either similar or slightly quicker times than Wittmann at this point.
Look at this. Eduardo Mortara adds yet more tenths. He was very nearly a second quicker than Wittmann last time.
I think Wittmann's on the radio complaining about his tyres, and I think I agree to him. His times are falling off. I think...
copy that. We are working on it.
I think BMW are scratching ahead. I think they realise they may have actually missed the best moment to pit Marco Wittmann in this race.
Well, they've got to pit him.
They have no choice. His tyres are falling off. But if they bring him in, they end up behind a whole batch of Audis. You're juggling and you're kind of working out which is the best strategy to take, knowing that both could actually put you in hot water.
Yeah, it could cost you the championship.
This is falling towards Edo Mortara as it stands at the moment.
Well, you say that as Mike Rockenfeller there. Past the car of Bruno Spengler. Look at Nico Müller down the outside.
That's at the BMWs. They just have no pace in these conditions.
And Miguel Molina as well.
They're all just driving past them. And that's what I'm considering is Wittmann's pace is not quick enough at the moment. And he's actually falling into this back.
So Mike Rockenfeller with Nico Müller and Miguel Molina. They've got past the P5 car of Bruno Spengler. Spengler drops right down the order now because Rocky is P5, Müller is P6, Molina is P7, so Spengler had lost three places, didn't he, and three critical places to Audi. In comes Maxime Martin, in comes Timo Glock. So all of a sudden, some of Marco Wittmann's wingmen are in.
I think they have to start pitting the BMWs out of the way now. As it stands, if Wittmann pits, he'll come out behind Resta.
So Glock. It's a 3.4-second time for Martin, which is not brilliant. It's 3.5 for Timo Glock.
Sorry, Dave, it's two poor stops for both Glock and Martin that time around.
So out come those BMWs once again.
What this could potentially do is maybe bring Glock and possibly Marta into play in the pack when Wittmann does.
Yes.
Right, Edo's coming in.
But I think Edo's okay because he's got 25 seconds to Rocky. He makes a stop and there's a 11-second gap ahead of him.
Whoa, there's a wheel off.
Box.
That's the Antonio Felix da Costa car.
Yeah, mate, sorry as well.
He's not having a good race at all. awful way for Antonio to end his DTM career, sadly.
So here is Eduardo Mortara.
Box in this lap.
And Wittmann's going to follow it.
We'll see now. This is key, Dave. This is absolutely key.
Right. We'll run the clock. If everything goes right, you should come out in front of Mike Rockefeller, but it needs everything to come out right. So unsafe release for Antonio Felix Costa, because of course the wheel has come off. Right, the team go to work on the Edo Mortara car. 3 seconds. Oh no!
No, I think they had to stop because Wittmann was coming.
So that would have been an unsafe release if it had been let go.
But that's no fun. Mortara has more than enough of an advantage, and it's 3.2 for Wittmann. It's okay, but it's not.
Watch the white line.
Here comes Rocky now.
So what we need here is Mike Rockefeller ahead.
Are you a racing gearista?
Wittmann's lost several places there. That's not really worked out as well as he had hoped. Seventh place.
So he is behind Paul de Resta.
But Rocky and Muller still have to pit.
He's effectively virtually fourth, isn't he now?
Fifth, I think it's four, yeah. Well, Blomqvist, it depends because they still have the Mercedes.
We've got Rocky, Muller, still to pit.
De Resta has stopped.
So Marco Wittmann needs to get past Paul de Resta. So there is Paul de Resta in the Mercedes-Benz, who has stopped. So on board with Marco Wittmann now, 21 and a half minutes of the race remaining. Mercedes showing a vastly, vastly superior pace to what they did yesterday.
Now Wittmann needs to get past.
Repeat, two cars behind you still have to stop.
If Wittmann gets past the rest, it's a big signal there for this championship, because Blomqvist will move out of the way from him. But right now they have that Mercedes in between them. That's holding Wittmann seventh place. When Rocky and Muller move out of the way, that'll bring Wittmann up to fifth. Well,
doesn't stop, does it? Drama continues. So Marco Wittmann.
Remember, pit stop light, Vietoris is the first car on your same lap.
There's Mike Rockefeller. There is Muller.
So it's Mortara, it's Rocky, it's Muller, it's an Audi top three as it stands at the moment. Vitoris fourth in the Mercedes, Blomqvist fifth for the BMW, sixth is the rest of the Mercedes, and then you've got to wait till seventh place for to see Marco Wittmann.
And Jürgen Hatt, we saw on the pit wall there. DRS being used by Marco Wittmann to try and attack Paul de Resta as they head up towards the hairpin. So Paul de Resta protects the inside line and sends Marco Wittmann to the wide outside. Marco Wittmann will go for the cutback now, but Paul de Resta has got enough pace, I think, to cover that off. Indeed he does. So Paul de Resta is able to deny Marco Wittmann. Wittmann will try for the switchback now to get up the inside potentially. Again, Paul de Resta is able to make that Mercedes as wide as he needs to try and, you know, de Resta is in his own race.
Well, it's actually working out well. What's working out well for Wittmann here is the fact, as we said a few moments ago, when Martin and Glock pitched, that they could actually play a part for Wittmann's race. They're sitting behind him right now. They're holding Rast at bay. They're holding Robert Wickens at bay. They're holding Jamie Green at bay.
So there is the Marco Wittmann car, Edo Mortara.
Yes, the Resta has stopped. Pit stop corrected, you are in P5.
Pit stop corrected, P5. Paul de Resta has stopped.
That's just enough, isn't it, Dave?
Yes,
that would be a 1 point victory for Marco Wittmann if he gets to P5 once Rocky and Muller pit. René Rast himself has now pitted from P11. That takes him out of the running.
Let me throw something else into this. Timo Scheider, who's currently running in P15 between Felix Rosenqvist and Daniel Junkadea. Audi, not yet pitted. It's further down the order, isn't he?
Yes.
Marco Wittmann again trying to get up the inside of Paul de Resta.
No risk, Marco, virtually behind P5.
Going into the next turn.
Wittmann's, he is putting a lot of pressure.
Correct. No risk. You are in P5. Pit stop corrected.
There's a yellow flag there.
How frustrated is Marco Wittmann going to be? He is sat behind Paul de Resta here.
He absolutely will, but he mustn't lose his head because he doesn't actually, at this stage, he doesn't need to pass Paul de Resta because he will still claim the championship by 1 point. And he doesn't want to push too hard because he don't want to make a mistake, possibly end up in an incident like we saw with Gary Paffett earlier on, as we see Rocky Pitt from second place.
So in comes Mike Rockefeller now, needs a blistering time from the ABT team rather than the Phoenix team, who Mike Rockefeller is driving for. 3.1 isn't too shabby, we've seen better.
But Rocky's done his job. I think he's done his job today, as have Munner, by breaking out ahead of Wittmann and making sure that when Wittmann did actually pit, he lost a little bit of time.
So there is Mike Rockefeller feeding back out now. Don't cross the white line, you'll be in trouble. If you do, he didn't. So Nico Müller with Christian Vitoris. Nico Müller yet to stop, of course. Christian Vitoris will have the inside line for the next turn.
And that's really not a battle that's on as such, because, as I said, Nico Müller has not stopped. Like Rocky, he's done his job. He's played into the pack after Wittmann had his stop. And but the job that Rocky and Müller did was they actually really made BMW have to think hard about the strategy, because BMW knew that whenever they pitted Marco Wittmann, he was always going to fall into an Audi pass.
Yes.
So by staying out as long as they did, Rocky and Müller really actually gave BMW very, very little choice. They had to take a risk.
No, absolutely right. I completely concur with you. I wonder whether they are holding on to Timo Scheider here.
I'm not entirely sure at the moment that Scheider will actually play into it in too much as we see Nico Müller play. Unfortunately, I think that drive-through penalty earlier on probably did actually take him out of the running.
Yeah. So, good time from the team for Nico Müller. 2.9 seconds. He's on his way back out again now.
Doris is now behind you. Was 1/10 quicker than you.
So 1/10 quicker, Christian Vitoris to Eduardo Mortara. And in comes Timo Scheider. 2 point. That is his last DTM pit stop.
Last pit stop of the season too.
4.4 now.
Mortara is racing off into the distance. I mean, interestingly enough, Blomqvist is ahead of de Resta in third place. The BMW pace still isn't actually...
So, Blomqvist allows Marco Wittmann through, so it's going to be Wittmann on de Resta now. So, overall fourth, and that would be more than enough, wouldn't it?
Absolutely, yeah, it would be. Blomqvist has given up basically the podium position, falling deliberately behind. Yes. He's gone wide, that's it.
Paul de Resta gets him back. And what Blomqvist does, of course, is gives Marco Wittmann the opportunity, the RMG driver. So it's now Edo Mortara, Christian Vitoris, Paul de Resta, Marco Wittmann. P4 for Marco Wittmann will be comfortable, won't it?
It will. That should be enough by 3 or 4 points, I believe.
Well.
What is the number? 4.3 now.
Marco Wittmann should be well protected now. And Eduardo Mortara, he can do no more than he has done. And as I say, Marco Wittmann in that position that he's in now, he's going to be protected from the behind. Here's the championship prediction then. Wittmann on 206, Mortara on 202. These three can play whatever game they want. All it's doing is helping Marco Wittmann ahead, isn't it?
And the other thing as well, I mean, Blomqvist's pace has fallen completely off. He's with Lewins in the second a lap, and now he's falling down into 37s.
everyone else just seems to be driving past him. Now, this is the other aspect of this, Dave, is we've seen the BMWs lose pace significantly as the stints have gone on in these conditions.
Yes, we have.
It's not completely done yet. Wittmann's still running reasonable times, but we saw him fall into the late 36s quite quickly in the first stint. He'll be hoping that that doesn't happen again as they race towards the checkered flag. There's only 13 minutes left.
Yeah, and in fairness, Green and Wicked, they're like 8 seconds down the road, aren't they?
Yeah, I think he has enough.
10 laps to go, we are in P4.
Wittmann just needs to sit tight, doesn't he?
Correct, this is all we need, P4 is enough.
But look at who's behind Wittmann in fourth place.
He's well protected. Well protected.
He's got Maxi Martin P5. He's got Team McLaughlin P6. He's got Tom Blomqvist in P7.
He is well protected. Edo Mortara has, well, he's done everything that he can possibly do. The risk of repeating myself, he can do no more, can he? He's got a 4.5 second margin over Christian Vettoris, and he's quicker than Christian Vettoris at the moment.
He's driven wonderfully. He showed aggression at the start when he needed to. He took one place off the starting line, and then he picked up drivers as he needed to, because he needed to get to the front. If he was to actually have any impact on the championship, the rest of it was just down to Wittmann and BMW.
Augusto Farfus, which I fear this is going to be a retirement for Augusto. He does put the car into the garage. It's been a very poor season for Augusto Farfus, and comes to an end with the car in the garage.
And it's disappointing, really, for Farfus, who, let's not forget, in 2013 was a championship contender. He lost the DTM title on the final day in 2013. So he's a guy with talent, he's a guy with speed, but...
How crucial, and this is a measure of Marco Wittmann's head, really, how crucial is it going to be for Marco Wittmann to want a podium? To take the championship by taking a podium. It would only be P3, and to do that, he needs to get past Paul de Resta. What I'm trying to say is, if he starts battling with Paul de Resta...
I'd be surprised if Marco started going down that road.
Okay.
He's got enough protection from behind, but if he actually starts... So he's not worried about being attacked, and if he starts fighting for P3, he doesn't gain anything in the championship. He doesn't gain anything in the championship, but could lose an awful lot if he ends up in an incident.
Exactly.
As we saw earlier on.
Save DRS from next lap on.
So even being told to save his DRS, so...
He doesn't need to do anything stupid, Dave.
There are two Mercedes behind you, then Wittmann. Remember track limit.
So Juncker Dea having another difficult day in the Mercedes. He's down in 13th place. And again, another driver who's had, I think, best to say, a difficult, challenging season is Danny Juncker Dea.
So we reached the stage where there is only 10 minutes of the race remaining. And the race is being led by the man that's P2 in the championship, Eduardo Mortara. And even if he wins this race, with Marco Wittmann running in P4, it will be enough for Marco Wittmann to take the championship title for the second time in his DTM career, let's not forget. Molina and Rockefeller there, who are...
Rocky just drive clean around the outside of Miguel, who won the race yesterday, by the way.
Eight laps.
So, of course, Mike Rockefeller is on much fresher tyres than Molina. So, but they're running down there, P13, P14. They're of no help to Eduardo Mortara at the moment, are
they? Well, their help came earlier on in the race when the pit stop cycle was carrying on. And that's all they really could have done, because at the start of the race, we saw the rest of the Audis were absolutely nowhere. They were all 13th and 14th downwards. All they could do was leave them out in the hope that Wittmann got stuck behind them.
Yes.
And, you know, it's gained. Wittmann was second before the pit stops. Let's not forget, he came out in P7.
Yes.
So it did work to a degree. But it looks at this stage as if the BMW pace is actually holding together. During the late 1 minute 35s, it doesn't really matter what Mortara is doing, because he's well out in front. But they,
the other drivers, Vickens in the Mercedes, he got green, he's in eighth place, green in the Audi in ninth place. They're actually losing time on Wittmann at this stage. It's not going to be a challenge.
Nico Müller having a real battle here with Daniel Juncker-Dea, but Nico Müller does go ahead to take what is effectively P15 away from Daniel Juncker-Dea. Eduardo Mortara crosses the timing line and banks another 135.664.
Juncker-Dea is losing so much. He's almost losing a second in the middle sector alone, Dave. He's just falling backwards. It's another miserable day for the former F3 champion.
In comes Felix Rosenqvist, which sadly that will signal probably a retirement. So under 8 minutes left to run. There are no real heavy-duty battles going on. I was just thinking to myself, I wonder if we had a late safety car, what that might do, but the likelihood of that is pretty remote, it has to be said. So, yeah, Felix Rosenqvist chooses to retire his number 88 car.
It's a miserable weekend for Felix, unfortunately. They've been rife with some... they really struggled to get the setup right this weekend. I mean, yesterday for Mercedes as a whole was a total write-off, and Felix just... it's not really worked out for him this weekend. Never really got into the groove of things, Mercedes. That happens sometimes with young drivers who are coming into their first season in DTM. But Felix, this is what, he's only his fifth race weekend. So, hopefully he'll be back stronger next year. And once if he has a full campaign under his belt. But that's 2017. We still have to finish 2016 first. Absolutely. And right now, Marco Wittmann fourth in this race. It's going to be enough for him to nab the title. Only 4 points ahead of Edo Matara. 6.5 minutes left in this race, plus one lap. I can't see anything significant changing in the last few minutes, Dave, unless a surprise has sprung amongst us.
Well, and it could be. Never. We can't write the story yet, can we? Because Edo Matara, 5.5 seconds to the good on Christian Vitoris, then it's Paul de Rester and Marco Wittmann. Then the protection that Marco Wittmann has by way of Timo Glock, Maxime Martin, Tom Blomqvist, before we get to the next Audi, which is running down there in P8, which is Jamie Green, who's a long way away from being able to support and help Eduardo Mortara. And bear in mind, it was going into this weekend, Jamie Green still had a mathematical chance of taking the championship himself, but we see a retirement from Daniel Juncker-Dea as well. So it's another Mercedes that's out. There is the number 12 car.
I think what may significantly annoy Mortara, or at least play on his mind to a degree, it's yesterday when he started eighth after losing a lot of time in practice and having a bad qualifying session and ended up finishing third. Molina won that race, and he'll play on his mind that the only guy ahead of him, the only non-Audi guy ahead of him, was Wittmann. And he said after the race, the car felt absolutely perfect. Had he another few laps, he probably would have easily been able to pass Wittmann, because Wittmann's pace wasn't great. And of course, Molina would have moved aside to allow him to take the win. So it's little moments like that. I've lost the title, to a degree.
Yes.
And we mustn't forget as well, little moments like that do lose title, but you know what? Great performances across an entire season win them as well. And that's what we've seen from Wittmann this
Absolutely.
Year.
Absolutely. Consistency has been key, hasn't it? So the RMG team, they're all huddled around the timing screen at the moment. They know that there's 5 minutes plus one lap to do for Marco Wittmann. Edo Mortara leading the race. And Timo Glock right behind Marco Wittmann.
5-7. Still P4.
And
there's no response there from Mortara, and I think
he knows.
He deep down.
Is there any friends
from
behind?
No.
That's telling. Was there any help from behind?
No.
And that is the situation where he. Yes, of course, we mentioned earlier on where the Rocky, Muller, etc. all played into the game by stalling BMW's tactics, but you've got the highest other Audi at the moment is Jamie Green in eighth place, and you need him, not eighth, you need him second, third, fourth, pushing Wittmann hard for positions, hard for places. Wittmann, okay, we've seen BMW lose an awful lot of tyre grip throughout this weekend. partially because they've been under pressure. They've really been able, having to fight hard at times. Wittmann right now, he's controlling his pace. This is a measured drive to the flag. He's not pushing, he doesn't have to push, and he's actually maintaining his tyres and everything else with this drive.
Yes, he's doing everything that he needs to do. But by the same token...
How many left?
So is Eno.
Three.
You can hear the desperation in Eno's voice. He's counting down each lap, saying, where is Wittmann? How many laps are? And it's all just falling away from him. It's not been enough, unfortunately. Wittmann still P4, 7.9 seconds behind race leader.
Stay focused.
And that's what he needs to do. As we just said, the gap to Wittmann is playing on his mind. What position Wittmann is in is playing on his mind. How many laps are there left is playing on his mind. Mortara just needs to finish the race. He can't do anymore. As we said over and over and over again this race, he started sixth place. He made a good start, fought his way to the lead. It looks like at this stage he's 5.3 seconds behind a Vittoris. He's going to win this race. He just cannot do any more than that.
No. So the order then in the race is Eduardo Mortara, Christian Vittoris and Paul de Resta. They're the top three. And with Marco Wittmann running in P4, as you can see, centre of the screen right now, that is enough for him to take the championship. As we look at Jens Marquardt on the BMW pit wall then, it's going to be a tense 2 minutes plus one lap for Jens Marquardt. Although Marco continues to do what he's been doing for lap after lap after lap. Should have absolutely nothing to worry about. Look at the sense of desperation in the Audi garage.
They know they've done their best. Edo's done his best. It's just not been enough. And they know Wittmann is just there to gain more than enough points. Four more points over Mortara.
Possible three laps to go. Three laps.
Just look at the...
It's a resignation to a degree.
4.6 now. 4.6.
But, you know, they can't do anymore. It's completely out of their hands.
It is. But... to take issue a little bit with what you said is that the team have done everything they can and the brand has done everything they can. Actually, if they'd have delivered a more reliable car during qualifying, I'm sorry to say.
True, absolutely agree with you in that instance. And okay. We say that there's been a little bit of unreliability with Audi this year. It hasn't really happened in the races, but it's been in the practice sessions where suddenly Edo loses 10 minutes, or it's happened in qualifying where Edo lost 10 minutes this morning.
Yep. But it is what it is. And let's celebrate the fact that Marco Wittmann, who has been the model of consistency across the season, and, you know, to be fair, he knew going into this race that he'd done everything that he possibly could. He's taken three wins. In addition to that, he's had another two podiums, and it's just banked points whenever he's been consistently in the points. There's only been, I think, across the entire season, three races where he has not banked points.
And that's the kind of consistency you need to take championships. Just a little bit of note too, we're two laps left to go. Mercedes, bit of a step up today from the absolute horror they had yesterday. Christian Vittoris.
4.1.
So the gap from Mortara to Vittoris is just over 4 seconds. But Vittoris, second place in Mercedes. De Resta, third place. De Resta, of course, yesterday was the highest place Mercedes, just on the very edge of the top 10 in what really was a... They can only describe as a horror day.
I know, but what I find extraordinary is how they can find the difference from one day to the next and how they can step the game up.
I guarantee you, Dave, if you went down to that Mercedes garage, you'd probably see a lot of very, very, very tired faces of mechanics who were working late last night trying to work out how to actually alleviate some of the handling problems that they've experienced at Hockenheim this weekend.
Well, we're reaching the closing stages of the race. The race that Eduardo Mortara is leading, but the championship that Marco Wittmann is heading to win. It'll be the second DTM championship for Marco Wittmann if everything remains the way it is at the moment. So Marco Wittmann, who's in the race, is running in P4, but that is going to be enough.
Last lap.
Eduardo Mortara starts his last lap.
Final lap, Marco.
So does Marco Wittmann. Marco Wittmann is one lap away from a championship victory. Eduardo Mortara has delivered everything he can, but it's going to be short by 4 points.
We saw the BMW mechanics taking their helmets off, taking their fireproof balaclavas off.
Still P4, no changes.
They're going to go across the pit lane to jump on the pit gantry and celebrate their man, Marco Wittmann, as he comes across the line in fourth place in a few moments' time. Enough to claim the championship, as you said, by 4 points.
Antti-Jürgen App then, look of resignation. He knows that his driver has delivered everything he can and there's nothing he can do. There's nothing the teams can do. All Edo could do is get the best position possible in the race. Well, you don't get a better position than to win the race. But he needed Marco Wittmann to be much further down the order than he is. And there is Marco Wittmann, who has just driven very maturely, very sensibly. And the team stand by to say P1 cool, because it is going to be P1 cool for the championship. Edo Mortara into the stadium section. He has got three more turns to do before he will head towards the checkered flag to take the race win. But it's going to be a bitter victory, because the win is not going to be enough for him to take the championship. He will be P2 in the championship. Edo Mortara heads towards the checkered flag as the fireworks erupt at Hockenheim.
Bravo, bravo. Non si poteva fare meglio.
Eduardo Mortara wins the race.
You did it, thank you.
But Marco Wittmann wins the championship with his P4 place. And the team celebrate, as you can imagine. RMG have delivered the championship for BMW with Marco Wittmann.
Thanks, thank you so much, Marco.
Stefan on the radio.
What a great season. Unbelievable.
His congratulations.
Second time champion. Yeah.
To Marco Wittmann, he is the champion. Edo Mortara.
So please take a lot of pickup.
As we watch Timo Scheider cross the finish line for the last time in DTM, Marco Wittmann is the DTM champion 2016. Eduardo Mortara wins the race, but is denied Leo Gorman by 4 points.
Can't argue, two-time DTM champion, second time in 30 years. We just mentioned there Timo Scheider crossing the line for the final time, and as a look of the realization on Edo's face, he gave it everything. He gave it absolutely everything. You cannot ask any more than what Edo gave today.
Do you know what? He must be the saddest race winner ever, because he knows that even though he's won the race, it is not enough to take the championship. Let's hear from Jens Marquardt now with Verena Wright.
Jens Marquardt, congratulations. The second title for Marco. You actually made it. How do you feel?
Very, very, very relieved. Oh, fantastic, really. It was a tough race. It was really tough at the start, and I was really worried. I mean, if you look at the piece of Edo's car that is sticking out of Marco's car, you know how they fought there. But it was just then a question of keeping a head down, and it was clear that it would be okay just to run it down to the line. That's what Marco did. That's what he did all year. I mean, for sure, he had more speed, but there was no point also finding Paul. So in that respect, I think, that's the deserved champion. And we're super happy. I mean, he just did a fantastic job.
You all did.
It's time to celebrate.
Absolutely. So congratulations, enjoy, and back to you.
Thank you so much, Verena. Well, Jens Marquardt, a very happy man.
Dave, as I was about to say a moment ago, we saw Timo Scheider cross the line, you know, the legend, his final DTM race. Marco Wittmann is now a two-time DTM champion. Yeah. There is a new generation of legends coming into this sport, and we're seeing Gary Paffett doing some very nice burnouts.
This is what motor racing and DTM is all about. It is a hugely, hugely competitive sport, but alongside the emotion of absolute delight, there is also sadness too, because for every winner there is always a loser too. And Eduardo Mortara, well, will feel it just went away from him. And you know, there are lots of other drivers too. You know, Robert Wickens, Jamie Green, you know, in many ways have done everything they can.
And that's good. That's what we like to see. And as we mentioned yesterday, these are two guys who came from Formula 3 Euro Series together. They've competed together for a long time. They've known each other for quite a long time. This is the generation, this new generation coming through, these are the DTM drivers who we're going to be talking about for a long, long, long time, Dave.
Well, I'm really pleased that Edo Mortara will do some donuts.
As is everyone else, it seems.
But we love it, and this is what it, for us, you know, motorsport is a real sport. The investment that's made, it's enormous in DTM, but you know what, it's entertainment as well. And that's why we love it, and long, long may it continue. You keep on doing the donuts, guys, because we love it. Jamie Green there, ex-Oval racer. Of course, he'll donut better than anybody else, truthfully.
Well, I hope they don't actually shear off too much weight by shredding the tyres.
Well, the podium is going to be... look at that, plumes and plumes and plumes of smoke down there. And
in there is a car.
Yes. And a
can't tell you which one.
Very happy driver. Well, that's Timo Scheider, who, you know, was in the press conference yesterday when he announced that he was going. He was exceptionally emotional. Here is confirmation of the race result then. Eduardo Mortara takes the win from Christian Vettori's Paul di Resta. Marco Wittmann, P4, was enough for him to seal the championship. There was Timo Glock, Maxime Martin, Tom Blomqvist, Jamie Green, Robert Wickens, and Martin Tomczyk finishing in the points for P10 in his final race. But Marco Wittmann has won the championship. And there he is being weighed. Positively snatches the piece of paper. The man, of course, who his local track is Nürburgring. He lives in the Nuremberg area. And he has won. And there, Eduardo Mortara, who, whilst he will inevitably feel so, so disappointed, he could not have delivered more. And he knows that. You can almost see that look of resignation, can't you? That Hans-Jürgen Apt there straight away to try and console him, and inevitably he is going to be upset. Oh, and how nice is that? Marco Wittmann and Edo together there. Sense of camaraderie is really, really goodly, and long may that continue. This Christian Vettori off, and his congratulations as well.
And a good podium for Christian.
Very good podium for Christian. I was about to say that. And this was nice as well. Look at that.
Yeah. They may be rivals, but
yeah, but it's good that there's that sense of camaraderie.
And as I said, they've been around a long time, raced together since back in the Formula 3 days, so.
Well, as we take a look at the backdrop of a very, very packed Hockenheim, here then, the Drivers' Championship, it went down to 4 points, look, between Marco Wittmann and Eduardo Mortara, 206, playing 202. Jamie Green, third in the championship. 1 point we thought may well go Jamie Green's way this year, but he will be back to fight another season.
I think probably one or more... disappointing aspects of the last few rounds is the drop off for Robert Wickens and Mercedes, and ended up actually falling almost 80 points behind Wittmann in the final standings. It's just not representative of his form up to, say, around Nürburgring time.
So Edo is.
And Timo waving to the crowd for one last time.
Christian Vettoris and Paul di Resta have had a fine race for Mercedes-Benz, and they're with Farina.
You guys really did have a fine race. Christian P2, Paul in P3, ending the race on the ending the season on a podium like that. How does it feel for you?
Yeah, really good. It was a difficult season. We were very strong at the beginning of the year. Very unlucky here and there, lost a lot of points. And now it's just great to have such a result at the end of the year for me and as well for the team. It was a hard fight coming through the field after the pit stop, but overall I'm really, really happy with it.
And Paul, you in third place, it was a tough fight. You were fighting really, really hard, and it's good to end the season like that?
Yeah, it's always good to end the season like that. We started the year with a win here. To be on the podium today after a bit of a mishap in qualifying, we weren't in the true grid, so who knows where we're further up, but to come from 18th to 3rd, I think so. It's least to say I'm pretty tired, so we'll enjoy the party tonight, and with the boys it's important, and the whole team, because everybody goes through the highs and lows of the season.
All right, well, thank you very much, and back to you.
Paul making a very good point there, because as we see the teams go through the highs, just think how the YAB team are feeling as going through the lows, despite Eduardo Mortara taking the win. He didn't take the championship, but there, that look of resignation.
And he knows he's done all he possibly could, but Wittmann was just too far up the order. It was a clever strategy by Audi. I think you have to admire that they saw they had several drivers further down the order that they knew if they left those drivers out, it would play into the game, forcing BMW into a position where, you know, do we pit him and end up behind a whole bunch of slower Audis, or do you leave him out and end up with pace so slow that when he actually eventually does pit, he's nowhere near the points. They had to roll the dice, they did,
yes.
And it worked out just well enough. It was pinch, really, really pinch point. A lot of very, very, very delighted BMW mechanics down there. I think there may be a little bit of a small celebration, shall we say, in the hospitality later on this evening. A small celebration.
You might be right. Glass of lemonade or two.
Yeah, you know, they may even go as far and have a cup of tea.
There we have it. The end. And, you know, what has been fascinating and brilliant for us is that the championship has gone to the final race of the season. Because, of course, last time Marco Wittmann won the championship.
He did it with a lot to spare.
Absolutely. So just proves, if nothing else, just how close it has been at times this year.
Absolutely, and the racing has been very good, very feisty. Feisty, certainly, we saw in this race. The incidents with Timo Scheider and Gary Paffin and Antonio Felix da Costa are anything to go by.
But it's sorry.
But it's part and parcel of racing.
It's what we want. It's what we want, isn't it? He is the DTM champion for 2016. He is Marco Wittmann.
Here he is. Congratulations. It's absolutely incredible. You're the new DTM champ, the second time that you've actually managed to snatch a title. How does it feel? It was a tough season, but now you are the new champion. How does it feel?
It feels great, to be honest. I mean, to be second time champion, it's something special. It was a tough season. We fought it till the end, the last race. And I have to say, it's unbelievable. The feelings are great. Full respect to Edo. He won today. He did as well a great job over the season. But at the end, we are champion. And big thank you to all my supporters, family, girlfriend, my team, BMW Motorsport. Unbelievable.
Congratulations again. And now here's podium ceremony.
So we await the dignitaries up there on the podium and the anthems to play out. Of course, the podium for the race, the 1-2-3, Edo Mortara, Christian Vettoris, and Paul di Resta. So Nico Edo Mortara on top step of the podium then. And here comes the trophy presentation. Managing director of Dectra, Johannes Vossenbrecker, makes the trophy presentation to Miguel Molina. To Eduardo Mortara, Miguel Molina. Gone back to looking at yesterday's result again, aren't I? Dieter Gummer then makes the team's presentation. They're fantastic trophies, aren't they? So Edo Mortara then receives the winner's trophy, which will be, I guess, scant consolation, won't it?
It will. It's been two wins this weekend for Audi, and they always seem to find form here at Hockenheim.
The Taurus is happy.
Well, after where they were yesterday, no doubt Mercedes was happy. A very good point, actually, Paul made earlier on. Very quietly, going from 18th to 3rd.
Yes.
We'll be very happy with that.
Chris Vepper then making the third place trophy presentation to Paul Di Resta. So, photographs to be taken now. And, well, Edo doing his best to raise a smile. So, trophy presentations done and dusted for the race win. Paul Di Resta then, Edo Mortara and Christian Vitouris enjoy the celebrations up there for the final race of the 2016 season in DTM.
It's been a good season, Dave.
It has been a good season.
Right down to the wire, and it's been an absolute delight to be able to talk with you about this championship on so many occasions this
year. Well, we've certainly enjoyed the action that's been delivered. And Paul Di Resta taking a fair old slug, and rightly so, he's been working hard.
The party's starting now, I do believe.
Super slow-mo shot there.
Somehow I don't think we're going to see many of the drivers bright-eyed and bushy-tailed in the airport tomorrow morning.
I don't think you will. I don't think many of them will have to get up at the stupid o'clock time I've got to. We've got to, I should say. But there we are. Oh, that is a fantastic shot, isn't it? As Christian Vitouris closes his eyes to try and avoid the onslaught of the champagne. Of course, the championship ceremony to come as well, as we take some more of these fantastic shots that we can bring you of the celebrations that were going on in the cars. And none bigger, of course, than Marco Wittmann having taken the championship, doing everything that he needed to do. And there was the somewhat disappointed Edo Mortara, who knew that despite everything that he did, it was not enough, and it wasn't going to be enough. But you can't take away the absolute consistency that I still think has really worked for Marco Wittmann this season. And, you know, a fair point that you've made is he's one of the new DTM legends in the making, isn't he?
Absolutely, you know, and he's still such a young guy.
Yes.
He's going to be around for quite a long time. He's going to be competing, hopefully, here for quite a long time. You know, he may still add many more championships to the two he's already won. That's all in the future, but, you know, that we have...
Look how happy his mum and dad are.
Absolutely, and you know, rightfully so.
Girlfriend, and as I say, his... local track, of course, is the Nürburgring. It comes from the Nuremberg area, or just close to Nürburgring. And, absolutely... wonderful shots. So we're not far away from the championship. Look at the track down there, packed with spectators to enjoy this podium ceremony. Renny Rast there, Dieter Gas then. In trouble with my names, isn't he? Dieter Gas then.
I'd be a bit surprised if it was Renny Rast taking the manufacturer's.
All right. Shut up.
Jamie Green third in the championship. Almost looks like he'd rather be somewhere else right now, to be honest.
Well. There goes Jamie Green. Super, super young man. Started his racing career, sorry for mentioning it again, on the ovals. Driving a Mini on the shale. Funny when, as Edo Mortara, when I was talking to Jamie recently, we were doing a slot car race in Audi, and as he said, when all these guys were driving their slot cars, I was driving real cars.
He does like to get that in from time to time, doesn't he?
The champion is Marco Wittmann. It was nice to see Jamie Green go across to Edo and say, come on, chap.
Yeah. It's as you said last night at the Timo Scheider conference, the camaraderie, it's nice. Something else.
So the national anthem plays out for Marco Wittmann. Hans-Joachim Stuck then, the DMSB president, makes the trophy presentation to Dieter Gas, who holds it aloft. The manufacturer's title goes the way of Audi.
They're a very impressive trophy.
They are. Abt then receive the team's trophy. Tell you what, you need both hands on those, don't you? Oh, steady on.
Don't drop it. I think he got saved there by Dieter Gas. Mm.
Herman Tomczyk then, who is the sport president from the ADAC, makes the trophy presentation to Jamie Green. P3. For Jamie. And Clemens Klinker, then board member for Dekra. And Edo Mortara receives the P2 trophy. Did everything he could to try and make it the P1 trophy today, but. And here comes the Champions Trophy. Axel Voorstoorn then, Senior VP of Deutsche Post, makes the 2016 DTM Championship Trophy presentation to Marco Wittmann. So behind the podium, the fireworks erupt in celebration at the 2016 Championship, going the way of Marco Wittmann. Ollie Sittler doing his best to battle against the noise of the fireworks going off behind the podium. He's the man in charge of the presentations up there on the podium as everyone holds their trophies aloft and moves forward for photographs. Now,
guys, one step forward, please.
One step forward, please. You try lumping that.
They're huge.
They are fantastic trophies.
Edo is trying. He knows that it's still going to hurt for quite a while. He's won the race, but only just lost the championship. And he'll be happy for Marco, but disappointed that it just didn't happen for himself. As the champagne sprays for one last time in the 2016 DTM season. And there's going to be an awful lot more champagne open tonight, Dave, I think.
Yes, I think you might be right. I think you might be right. So, 2016 DTM champion then is Marco Wittmann. Oh. He has done it. And the champagne is consumed on the podium. Marco Wittmann waves to all the fans out there who have supported him and continue to support him. And now, two times a DTM champion for Marco Wittmann. And, well, it's always a great shame when the season comes to an end, because it means we do have a small period of relaxation before the start of the next season. So, Edoardo Mortara, wonder how he is feeling. Verena will find out. She's with him now.
Edo, it's probably impossible to console you. You are fighting like a crazy man. I mean, you really were. You gave everything, and you know you gave your best. You won the race, but it just wasn't enough. 4 points. So I've got to ask, how are you feeling?
It's a mix of feelings, obviously. You know, it's nice, you know, to have won, you know, the fifth race this season. And I was just, you know, on the podium and thinking, like, it's incredible that after winning 5 races, you know, you cannot clinch the title. But I mean, I'm proud of what I did this season, and for sure there will be hard feelings about, you know, what happened in Zandvoort and after. But I mean, yeah, in a way, I think I will have to move forward and to try to forget about it.
Well, but you can be very proud of you. Plus, it's 4 points. I mean, you know what you're capable of. Plus, there's always next year, right?
Yeah, I mean, but there is only one winner, and today we were not. And I have to say also congrats, you know, to Marco. And if I'm happy about one guy beating me, actually, Tim, we've been teammates. We were actually pretty good friends, and he did a tremendous job this year. He deserves probably as much as me to win this championship. So, in a way, you know, to lose against him, it's a bit a better feeling, you know, to lose against, for example, Timo Glock.
Thank you so much. And I've got to be said, though, I mean, Edo really did make the championship in the end very, very exciting. So I hope you enjoyed as much as we did. We did some nail biting today. And, well, that's it from Hockenheim, the grand finale. And thank you to all you guys. Hopefully see you next year. So here are the highlights. Enjoy, and bye-bye.